So for the last few months, I've been trying to make better use of my notes out of church. I switched to an iPad not too long ago, and I'm really finding it having the iCloud notes on one side so I can scribble notes like you see here. And then the Bible split screen on the other side of the iPad really works well. I can quickly take notes as things are coming up. And then as I have time, I can research some of the scriptures being talked about and make more notes. It really works well. This is kind of split into two because somehow I did a page break in the notes during church and don't know iPad well enough on how to fix that and just kind of left well enough alone. But one thing I've really been trying to do, and I made a note here, is take time to process. This is for me to talk about more in our meetup this week, but it's really what I'm talking about here is taking time after any meeting or event or church service to process what I've written down. And so you see my notes here. This sermon was A New Horizon. His main topic was John 10:10, called it Finding Freedom. And really his whole point was comparing how Jesus had the disciples as his small group and how we could benefit from small groups. And so the ways he worked with his small group, the way small groups help you. And it was pretty neat. So lots of notes, lots of different scripture references. I kind of jotted them down, made some notes in the Bible app. But the Bible app itself, at least the main one I use, the YouVersion app, is a wonderful app, but not great for taking notes in and referencing later. For that, I've been using a program called Rome Research, which I have a separate video that kind of gives an overview of Rome you should check out. But what it is, it's a note-taking app, just a web app for now, but works pretty well on phones. But for me, I like to process later. It's not quick enough to use on a phone, just typing on the keyboard. I'd rather scratch stuff down with a pen on the iPad. But you can make notes inside of notes and then link things from one to another. So if you put double brackets around, kind of like in Wikipedia, it creates and links to a page called Piedmont Church. And so if I were to click that, I can see all the times that was referenced. And this is where it can get really cool, I think, for the Bible over time. So I keep referencing verses. I can go back and see the context I referenced them, notes I referenced from. It can just come a big web of references. If I were to go to my graph overview, this is well beyond just the Bible. I use this for all kinds of notes, a lot of marketing stuff in here. Just anything that comes to mind ends up in Rome. You can see all the connections between different things. It's really neat. And this is still fairly new, so it could get even better. So if I expand my notes from today that I processed after church, I took the iCloud notes on one side of my screen and kind of worked my way through the other. But I put the name of the sermon, linked it to Ike. Again, same idea. But where it really got interesting, I've kind of figured this out over the last few weeks, is how to handle the actual scripture references themselves. And so what I've done is I'm starting to create a page for every every chapter of the Bible. So John 10 has its own page. So if I click on John 10, you can see here is all of John 10. The reason I've put John 10 forward, John 10, 5, instead of just John 10 at the top and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so I can reference individual verses easily from elsewhere as I go through. And I'll show you how that looks in a minute too, and then you'll be able to see how things are referenced back in the actual scripture when you're in there. So the focus is on John 10, and I pulled in where it says John 10, 10, and actually pulls in the text of it. I didn't type it here. It references it from the other place. So if I were to go in here, if you do double brackets, of course, it lets you link to another page like you see for a lot of these. But double parentheses lets you link to a single line in any other page in your Rome, which, you know, is going to be thousands or tens of thousands of pieces of data, so it'd be hard to find things. But if I have them named that way, it's a little easier. It doesn't work perfect. I think the colon maybe messes them up. But I type John 10, 10. I can find it pretty quick in here. It's okay, there's John 10, 10. It actually pulls in that verse for me, which, one, is kind of nice. So in my notes, I can actually see the text of the verse without having to type it again. But where it's really nice is if I'm in John 10 looking at something, I see a reference over here that this verse has been referenced one time. And I can click on that, and it'll quickly show me, oh, it was referenced here. Okay, there's notes from Piedmont Church that day. I can see what's going on. And if I want, I can just run back out to that day and see everything I talked about that day and how it kind of fit into small groups and all the references there. So it's those little notes in there that, again, for now is not much. It's just the one there, I think, in this whole thing. Most of these are new, but over time, this should become somewhat littered with notes. And so if I reference John 10, 10 again, I'll see a two there and say, oh, we talked about this before. And I can click and see the different ways it was talked about, and that could be kind of neat. And so really, that's all I've done here. Today was kind of a lot of work because he referenced a lot of different books, a lot of different chapters, and mostly ones I've not added to Rome yet. Most days, though, there's fewer chapters I need to add, which is less cutting and pasting. And then over time, of course, as we re-reference some of the more popular ones, you know, it's going to come back up. Yeah, I already have it in here. I can just kind of reference it and move on with stuff. So I still need to do better with making more thoughts about what was said. This was really more verbatim, kind of what he said, a small group for Jesus, and then his old things. You know, Jesus invited them, he taught them, he served with them, he cared for them, and the references. But over time, I'd like to add more details in there, again, to make it more useful. And this is the kind of thing, really, the whole idea, I think, with Rome, I mentioned in that other video, is it's useful now. It's cool now. I like this, but I think it's going to be real useful the more stuff you put in it. With most apps like Evernote that I used before, or even Notion to some degree, the more stuff you put in it, it gets a little more unwieldy and hard to manage. This is kind of the opposite. Right now it's here, but it's not that useful. If I, you know, go into Proverbs here, I see the one little note on 17 that I made today. But over time, as I have dozens of notes or hundreds of notes that I'll talk into this, it becomes pretty valuable to link things around from one to another. So I'll link the other video in the notes in the description for this video so you can check it out so you can see more about Rome. But if you're looking for a way just to kind of get your Bible notes in one place, this is a good one to consider. Thanks.